محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. In regard to the aspect that we were reading in Usul al-Sunnah by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the shar'iyyati iqam al-hudud, the legislation of establishing the legal punishment. And as we mentioned, yani amr al-hudud naw'un min al-fiqh. It is one aspect of fiqh. But Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he brought this aspect that is dealing with fiqh in a book that is a book of aqidah, a book of principle or foundation of the religion. So we understand from that the reason why Imam Ahmad rahimahullah pointed out a mas'ala of fiqh and bring it in an issue of aqidah. And if one was to be asked, لماذا, why, when Imam Ahmad bring an issue, that is an issue that is known of fiqh, because iqamat al-hudud, and establishing the legal punishment, is set for this or for that, because of this, because of that, that is, barakallahu fikum, dealing with the issues of the of fiqh. It's dealing with the issues of the jurisprudence. But if one was to be asked, barakallahu fikum, limadha wada Imam Ahmad rahimahullah this issue, why did Imam Ahmad put this issue of fiqh in this issue that is an issue of principle, foundation of the religion? And the simple answer is because you have people of deviation that are denying the establishment of the legal punishment of the had, wala siyama al-rajm. Among them are who? The Khawarij. Yes, those who are using the rational, what are they called? Aqlaniyun, ahsanta. They are the Aqlaniyun. And one of the examples that Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabiri hafidhahullah gave of the Aqlaniyun was who?
Yusuf
al-Qaradawi, the well-known, the one that wrote the book Al-Halalu wal-Haram. So therefore, now any principle or anything that is that you have another deviant group that opposes Ahl-Sunnati wal-Jama'ah, doesn't matter what portion of the religion it belongs, it will come to be now a matter of aqidah. Mathalan, Al-Barbahari mentioned the issue of Al-Mas'al al-Khuffayni, the issue of wiping over the socks, right? The issue of wiping over the socks. And he mentioned that this is from the foundation of the religion. Limadha, because you have people from deviant ones that are not taking the issue of wiping of the socks. So therefore, wiping over the socks is no longer an issue of fiqh alone, but rather it is an issue of aqidah. Because you have some of the deviant groups that do not take the issue of wiping over the socks. So the rajm, we know what was the meaning of ar-rajm. Ma ma'ana ar-rajm in the language. What is the meaning of ar-rajm in the language? Na'am. Ala jidar. Qarab. On the wall. Kabul al-adab. Ya man ala jidar. Qarab. On the wall. Kabul al-adab. Yes, na'am. Fadal. To throw, yes, al-rajm. Yes, this is the meaning of it in the language. Al-rajm, in the language, in the Arabic language, it means these two things. It means to throw something, or to have a guessing lie. Right? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, right? The word rajm in what surah? Ismail. In surah Al-Kahf. In surah Al-Kahf, he mentioned about the word rajm. And this was in regard to when the people, they were were they? Three men and a dog, four. Four men and a dog, five. Five men and a dog, six. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this rajma, right? That they were guessing. It was a guessing lie. So we mentioned now in the istilah of the sharia, in regard to the sharia, ma ma'ana al-rajm. Ma ma'ana al-rajm in the sharia. In the sharia. No, in the sharia, هو يعني بينا باستلاح اللغة. لكن من ناحية الشرع. من ناحية الشرع. In the aspect of the religion. الأسماء. Stoning? Stoning to death? No. Huh? Yes, stoning the adultery to death. Stoning him. That's important. Is it with sandals? La. Then therefore, what is the jinns is important. It's not like you're going to be stoning them like a piece of wood until they die. La, but rather he is with the stone, the hajar, the stones. Throwing stones to a person that fell, a muhsin that fell into zina until he is dead. So mentioned, Shaykh Ubaidi mentioned that there are two conditions. There are two conditions for the individual to what? To be stoned. Two conditions for the person to be stoned. Number one is what? He has to be muhsin. Al-Ihsan has four conditions. For a person to be muhsin, it has four conditions. Number one, he has to be baligh. He has to reach the age of maturity. Number two, Abdullah, he has to be married before, meaning he has to consummate the marriage before. Number three, he has to be ذو عقل. He has to be sane. Number four, حر. He has to be free. If these four are there, then the individual, barakallah fikum, he is Muslim. Nah. Muslim? La. La. Because هذا نتكلم بنسبة الزواج. لأن زواجة الكفار إذا أسلم يعني لا يحتاج ب يعني بعقد جديد. If you can't are married, they accept Prophet them as Islam. They don't need to be doing the marriage again. They already married. Right? And this is an act of worship that Islam will be the first condition. Alaykum salam. So he mentioned, and the second one, the second condition is what? The second condition, Omar?
To have the witnesses.
Yes, to have witnesses or? The admission, the individual to confess. These are the two conditions for the rajm to take place. Number one is a person has to be muhsin. Number two is that the individual has to be either the proofs are established against him or he confessed. And that which we have, barakallahu fikum, also mentioned was the issue of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prior to that. That the ayat has been read in regard to al-rajm, as Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu wa adahi mentioned. فَمَاذَا قَالَ Umar? What did Umar say? What did Umar say? What did Umar say? نعم, Abu Ahmed. Yes. Before that. قبل ذلك, Abu Ahmed الثاني. Before that,
we stoned during the time of
the before that, قبل هذا كله. أبا أسماء.
Sitting on the member.
أحسنت. بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خير. Yes. The Umar ibn Khattab was sitting on the minbar. What minbar? Yes, the minbar of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a must al-muraja'ah qabla maji'ina fi al-fasl. We have to revise before we come to the class. Ahsanta. That Ibn Umar radiyallahu anhu, he was sitting on the minbar of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Kamil, continue. Naam.
And he said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the one that they said with the truth.
Yes. Inna Allah ba'atha rasulahu bil haqq. That Allah indeed sent the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the truth. After that, Muhammad. Yes. You're trying to look where you can find it, huh? Slick.
People read it.
Before that, he said, indeed Allah sent the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the truth. Yes. Yes, and he revealed the book to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We were drilling like this for we can have this sequence, barakallahu fikum. Tayyip, after that. So he said, in Umar, he was sitting on the minbar of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Right? He was sitting on the minbar of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that sent the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam bil haqq, with the truth. And he sent down the book, he revealed the book to him. And then? Yes. I'm listening.
See, from that book he has...
Oh, are you reading? No, I'm saying somebody that revised. You were looking, man.
And that we used to read the
ayahs. Yes. He said, فَكَانَ مِمَّا And it was from those verses that was revealed. The ayat of Ar-Rajm. He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the truth. And he revealed the Quran unto him. And he, فَكَانَ مِمَّا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْهِ آيَةُ الرَّجْمِ And it was from those ayat that was sent to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the verses of Ar-Rajm, the verses of stoning. Now he mentioned, فَقَرَأْنَاهَا We read it. After we read it, we memorized it and we understood it. We read it, understood it, memorized it. And then he came to say, فَخَشِينَا That we fear that a time will pass, meaning for a long time, and a people will come and will say that, فَمَا وَجَدْنَا آيَةُ الرَّجْمِ فِي الْقُرْآنِ We have not seen the verses that talks about الرَّجْمِ in the Qur'an. طيب. And then he gave us the condition of الرَّجْم. He said that the رَجْم is for the one that is for the muhsin. He said for the muhsin. And he gave the category from the رِجَال and وَالنِّسَى. This is to exclude what was mentioned in the condition, that it is the individual has to be baligh. He say al-rijal. Al-rijal. He didn't say the atfal, or the sigar, or the abna. He didn't say that. He say al-rijal. And al-rijal, the word al-rijal is showing the age group of those individuals. Naam. The condition, awwalan, we mentioned the condition was al-bulugh. The atfal are not baligh. So if they are married, if the atfal that are married, they are not considered to be muhsin. Because one of the condition is missing is al-balagh, al-bulugh, ma'athira. There's another thing, it's another issue. But not al-rajm. Here natakallam bi amri al-rajm. We're talking about the rajm. Yes. But inshallah, when we finish with the rajm, we will deal with it point by point, inshallah. Awesome. So Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu, he went to say, he say, إِذَا قَامَتْ الْبَيِّنَ If the proofs are established against him, أَوْ كَانَ الْحَبْلِ Or there is pregnancy, أَوْ الْإِعْتِرَافِ Or there is confession. So any of this, barakallahu fikum, it indicates that the person had fall into is to be established the had upon them. وَقَدْ رَجَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ شَأْمَنَ النَّجْمِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has indeed established a rajm. And the first example we took was who? Sulaiman.